Now, what is this I not replacing? By now, you should be familiar why I replace those term by I not. So, for capacitor, at any instant of time, we have studied that. But very clearly I told, the entire game show here is to understand the variation of voltage and current. If it is a pure capacitor, it is current leading voltage by 90 degrees. Therefore, it is the opposition offered by the capacitor. It is called capacitive reactance. Hello students, this is SD sir again from the Temple of Excellence, Vidyashram Pre-University Mysore. Again, continuing my discussion on the alternating current chapter, where I have already discussed the previous two sessions in view of pure resistive and pure inductive circuits. In my today's class, I shall discuss about a pure capacitive AC circuit. Nee solpa nenpu maarkondre, when there was only a resistor which was connected to an AC circuit, which I compared to an ideal understanding family. Why? In such a circuit, current and voltage were always in phase. Whereas, when I considered an AC circuit with a pure inductor, clearly there was a phase difference of 90 degrees between voltage and current, or voltage was leading current by 90 degrees in such a circuit. And we also defined something called inductive reactance, where it was the opposition offered by an inductor to the flow of AC current. Yav riti denote madidvi adana XL, which was also omega L, which was also 1 by or 2 pi FL. Continuing my discussion today, I will discuss an AC circuit with a pure capacitor. AC circuit with a pure capacitor. We will now understand the nature of an AC circuit when only a capacitor is connected to it. How voltage and current behaves in an AC circuit where there is only a capacitor connected. Fine. I will consider a pure capacitor. In pure capacitor andre koltogiruttanda kolidiruntada? No, I've clearly told, if you observe the circuit, there is only a capacitor connected in it. There is no resistor, no inductor, only a capacitor was connected in it. So consider a pure capacitor of capacitance C. The capacity of the capacitor is C, connected to an AC source as shown in the figure. So there is a capacitor of capacitance C which is connected to an AC source as shown in the diagram. Now the applied instantaneous voltage, the voltage across the terminals of the AC at a time t, adu nen karuduve instantaneous voltage, is given by V equals V naught sin omega t. Everything as I have done in my previous two derivations. So the applied instantaneous voltage, the potential across the terminals of the AC, is given by V equals V naught sin omega t, where how did we describe the terms? V naught was the peak value, or it was the maximum value of the alternating voltage, and we say omega was 2 pi f, which was called the angular frequency. Now, what is the basic use of a capacitor? At any instant of time, we have studied that a capacitor will store charges. The basic use of a capacitor is to store charges. Therefore, the charge on the capacitor, what will be the charge on the capacitor at a time t? I write Q equals C into V. Yellinda sikto, how did sir write Q is C into V? Very simple. It is by the definition of capacitance. Capacitance chapter alodit valva. Capacitance is Q divided by V. So charge is C into V. That is what I have written here. So the charge on the capacitor at a time interval t is Q equals C into V by the basic definition of capacitance. But what is V equal to? V is nothing but equal to V naught sin omega t. So substituting for V, we have C V naught sin omega t. So substituting for V, Q is C V naught sin omega t. Now, equation 1 Very clearly, I have described something with respect to voltage. V equals V naught sine omega t. But very clearly I told, the entire game show here is to understand the variation of voltage and current. So now I need current. Charge is here. See, V naught sine omega t. Charge id mel current en agutte. Good. It is nothing but dq by dt. Therefore, substituting, so I is equal to dq divided by dt. This is the basic definition of current. So, what is Q equal to? Yes, from the previous slide, very clearly, Q is equal to C V naught sine omega t. Differentiating that, constants are taken outside the differentiation symbol. So, C V naught d by dt of sine omega t is omega cos omega t. En martidive, we are differentiating this expression. D by dt of C V naught sine omega t. C and V naught constant salva. C is the capacitance. It cannot change. V naught peak value, maximum value. You cannot have any other value more than that. So it is a constant. So d by dt of sine omega t. So d by dt of sine omega t, your basic principles of differentiation, omega cos omega t. Now this entire term becomes constant. V naught omega c cos omega t. Now I want to express this expression in terms of a standard function. So, gamanisilen Martini, this V naught I replace or I keep in the numerator itself. I keep V naught in the numerator itself. This omega c has to come to the denominator. So denominator bandaga, it becomes 1 by omega c, reciprocal alva makla. So V naught na I have retained as it is in the numerator. I want omega c to come to the denominator. When omega c is coming to the denominator, it becomes 1 by omega c. Yen ulkolto cos omega t. And this cos omega t I can write as sine omega t plus pi by 2. In the previous session you saw, minus cos omega t was sine omega t minus pi by 2. This is cos plus cos omega t, which is sine omega t plus pi by 2. Again I say, please to understand, mathematics is a tool, a strength to understand physics. Your trigonometry should be very, very strong when we are doing all such waveforms. So again I repeat, from this basic expression, V naught retained in the numerator divided by omega C. I am pulling it to the denominator. When it comes to the denominator, it has to become 1 by omega C. This cos omega t is written as sin omega t plus pi by 2, or I write this expression, I manipulate this expression as I equals I naught sin omega t plus pi by 2. Now what is this I naught replacing? By now you should be familiar why I replace those term by I naught. So this I naught is replacing this first factor, which is V naught divided by 1 by omega C. The entire thing, V naught divided by 1 by omega C. And again, this I naught is the peak value of alternating current. So quickly to summarize, since I wanted current, I told I is dq by dt. What was q? C V naught sin omega t. And as you all know, by the principles of differentiation, constants are taken outside the differentiation symbol. C V naught was a constant. D by dt of sin omega t is omega cos omega t. So rearranging that expression, V naught omega C cos omega t. V naught, it is kept in the numerator. Omega C comes to the denominator. It becomes 1 by omega C. Sin omega t plus pi by 2. Because cos omega t is sin omega t plus pi by 2. And this term V naught divided by 1 by omega C is replaced by I naught, which is the peak value of the alternating current. Now, as usual, we will check whether there is any phase difference between current and voltage. Equation 1, when I analyze voltage, it is simply omega t. Equation 4, if you analyze current, there is an additional term plus pi by 2. Now, is there a phase difference? Evidently, plus pi by 2 or 90 degrees. Who should lead in this case? My dear students, current has a phase of plus pi by 2. Naturally, current is plus pi by 2. Therefore, current has to lead voltage in a purely capacitive circuit. Nenpittukollodage. See, capacitive circuit. Capacitor. Current. Yes. Capacitor stores charges. When you have charge, there is current. So, if there is a capacitive circuit, current has to lead voltage by pi by 2 radians or 90 degrees. So, please to understand, if it is a purely resistive AC circuit, no phase difference between voltage and current. If it is a purely inductive inductor, voltage leads current by 90 degrees. If it is a pure capacitor, it is current leading voltage by 90 degrees. Therefore, if I analyze the phasor diagram, again, the first curve is always the voltage curve. Again, pi by 2 radians, peak value, it has attained the peak value here. Again, the peak value on the negative axis. But if you observe the current curve, the current is way ahead of voltage. Previously, current was lagging negative axis a little when it was an inductor. Since this is a capacitive circuit, current is leading voltage, again you observe, by pi by 2 radians or 90 degrees. Therefore, we clearly analyze here saying that in a purely capacitive AC circuit, current has to lead voltage by 90 degrees. Now, just coming back to this expression again, where we have I naught is V naught divided by 1 by omega C. I'll compare this with I is V by R. Now if you observe, here in place of opposition, we have something called 1 by omega C. V naught by R barbeko. R is the opposition. Instead of that R, 1 by omega C. And we say this 1 by omega C is XC, which denotes something called capacitive reactance. As we studied inductive reactance, XC, not really, inductive reactance, XL, was directly equal to omega L. XC equals 1 by omega C, capacitive reactance. And what is capacitive reactance? It is the opposition offered by a capacitor to the flow of AC current. If the opposition is offered by an inductor, adana inductive reactance ant karadvi. If it is the opposition offered by the capacitor, it is called capacitive reactance. So capacitive reactance is XC, which is equal to 1 by omega C. So my dear students, I have explained the nature of the AC circuits when you have a pure inductor, capacitor and a resistor. If it is a pure resistor, no phase difference. Current and voltage are in phase. If it is an inductor, yes, voltage leads current by 90 degrees. Capacitor, current leads voltage by 90 degrees. Now, with all these three concepts, with the basic idea of resistive, inductive and capacitive circuits, in my next session, I come up with a very, very important classical derivation called series LCRAC circuit. Wait for that. But before doing that, go through three sessions. It will help you to understand the derivation better. Until then, thank you.